Santa Yogis. If you're just tuning in, I just did a video a couple minutes ago talking about what we needed for practice. Again, if you missed that, it's just going to be one or two pillows, or if you have a bolster, you might prefer a bolster, and that's perfect. Otherwise, have just a blanket for underneath your head, and we'll start lying down. I'll be talking to you here, and I'll join you in the poses after our first opening pose. So go ahead and lie down. And then begin to really just settle into your body and your breath. We're here for an hour together, finding our intention today as surrender. So you can be lying down with your head on your pillow or a blanket. You can bring another pillow under your knees or your bolster under your knees, and then just start to And then while you're lying down, just grab hold of the outsides of your thighs, bring them in together. Grab hold of your shins and rock yourself side to side while you're on your back. Feel your spine release. Your head will be on your blanket or your pillow, and just find a fetal pose on your right and feel your left ribs lift as you breathe in and fall as you breathe out. Bring your left hand to the earth, press into your left palm, lift yourself up. And our first pose is going to be a restorative child's pose. And I'll show you how to do this. First, you might take your blanket open and set your knees on top of it so that your knees don't hurt. If full flexion of the knees doesn't work for you, so bending your knees really hurts, you can rest your body just on your belly and have a prone pose here. If you've got a bolster or a pillow, whichever you have works perfectly for this, you'll place it just between the tops of your kneecaps. Bring your hands on either side of your prop. On your inhale, you'll lift your heart. On your exhale, you'll place your belly, your chest, and one ear down onto the bolster or the pillow. If you're on a pillow and it's still too low, maybe stack two pillows or stack blankets on top of your pillows. But take the first 30 seconds of all of your restorative poses to get yourself as comfortable as possible. I'll tell you when you're at halfway so that you can switch gears. So first we start with a restorative child's pose. your head and switch ears whenever you're ready. Bring your opposite ear down. And take an honest check-in here. What can you soften? What can you let just go here? What can you surrender a little bit more to this pose, to the earth beneath you, to your bolster? What can you just let go of here? Take two full breaths here. And at the end of your second breath, begin to draw your chin through the middle. Lift your chest, press into a tabletop very, very slowly. And perhaps move your bolster off to the side, just for a breath or two. Maybe give yourself some cat-cow, maybe sway, maybe stretch one leg or the other. The next three breaths are just for you to explore what your body is craving right now. If your bolster is still vertically in front of you, great. If you moved it, bring it back vertically in front of you. Again, you can do this with stacked pillows, one or two, just in front of you. Our next pose is deer, but it's also called prone twist. So it's our supine, it's our twist, but instead of doing it supine, we do it on our bellies. So bring your knees over to the left of your prop, whether it's your bolster or your pillow, and sit your bum down. So you're sitting on your right bum cheek, and the short edge of your prop, whether it's your pillow or your bolster, or stacked pillows, you're going to lift your heart, hands on either side, lower belly, chest, left ear down. Now, if the left ear doesn't work for you, you can always switch to the right at any point. The neck, the stretch through the cervical spine is just an option. You can let your legs sprawl out as much as you want, but this is a deer twist. So go ahead, get into it. Stay here and see again, what can you surrender? What can you get a little bit heavier? Take three full breaths right here. And at the end of your third breath, press your palms down, turn your chin through the middle, and begin to lift up your chest. To get to the other side, all we'll need to do is turn away from our bolsters. Take your knees over to the other side. Land on your left sit bone. So I'm sitting, my side body's facing the front, and the short edge of my bolster or my pillow or my stacked pillows are right in front of me vertically. Hands on either side. Lift your heart, roll it down. Again, your right ear can come down on this side. If that doesn't feel good, you could bring the left ear. So no stress, whatever works for you. Feel like you've surrendered. What might you do to surrender a bit more here in this shape? Do you feel soft in your body, in your mind, in your spirit? Feel the softness get really bone deep here. Start to take your three breaths here. And at the end of your third breath, your chin will return to center. Bring your hands outside of your bolster. Really slowly crawl your way up. Now from here, I will demonstrate the next pose. Me going sideways, you guys stay exactly as you are. Your bolster's still vertical. You might, if you have low back tension or low back stress at any point, you might fold up a blanket and sit on it. Otherwise, coming into our first back bend, turn your knees away from your bolster. So your bolster is vertically in front of you. You're going to turn your knees away from your bolster, blanket at the edge of your bolster, underneath your bum. You're going to lean really close to the bolster and lean all the way back. Sorry, you guys can't get my full view here, but as long as you can see my spine, my low back, I'm going to inch and wiggle until I feel very comfortable and my palms face up. That's the most important part of the pose, is that your arms, your palms face up. Now you can bring a bend to your knees if you need. You can take your butterfly again, or you can go straight legs. This is whatever you'd like. As long as your palms face up, so that your chest can stay wide open. Naturally, your chest lifts here. Again, you can do this with your pillow vertically behind your spine, either one or two stacked pillows. Spine sink heavier. And notice what you're feeling here. Our first heart opener, it might be kind of vulnerable for you to lay with your chest broad. You might feel exposed, or you might feel free. You might feel completely at ease, but wherever you are, try to find a little bit more surrender. Really be with whatever you're feeling here. And know that no matter what, you are okay right now. You are safe right now. You are this beautiful breathing being, receiving all the love right now. You can just remember that open palms in this pose means an open heart. Really let yourself explore your what this opening stirs up for you. Almost there, just a couple more breaths. And tune into your three deep breaths. See this time if you can, as if send your ribs east-west instead of up and down north-south. See if they can move out to the sides. Be not afraid to take up space here. That is what your practice is here for. At the end of your third breath, bring the same bend to your knees that you did earlier. Lift your bum up like you're doing a tiny little bridge, and then bring your bolster or your pillow or pillows underneath your low back for restorative bridge. Now you might wiggle your prop around, maybe get it lower under your bum, maybe get it higher under your back. It really just depends on where you like it the best. Be here. You can take your arms up overhead. Let your fingertips touch. You might bring your hands to your belly if this is a very intimate pose for you. It is vulnerable. Again, you've done. This is your third of three heart openers that we're practicing today. If you do want to make this deeper, you might straighten your legs and get more of your psoas line open. Front of the hip flexors get a stretch. Otherwise, you can keep your knees bent. This is perfect as it is. And just stay here and take 4 more deep breaths into your belly. At the end of your 4th breath, if your legs are out long, bend them again with bent knees. Take 1 foot up and then the other. So for Viparita Karani, you might wiggle your bolster or your pillow around to get your back really comfortable and just let your legs lift and let the blood rush down them. If this feels really numbing in your feet and that's uncomfortable for you, numbing sensation is normal, but if it's uncomfortable for you, take as if a happy baby. But don't grab onto your feet. Just let your knees naturally fall towards your shoulders. And you guys stay either legs up or happy baby. As I will prepare for your meditation, stay and breathe. You might even find a super gentle sway here, massaging out your low back, letting your knees soften, letting your heart rate slow down in this very nourishing pose. Bend to your knees again whenever you're ready. Your feet will come down, your hips will lift up, and slide the bolster all the way down so that it's underneath your knees. If that's not enough, you might stack pillows. Do what you need to get very, very comfortable here. Perhaps put an eye pillow over your eyes, if that helps you. And enter into your land of Shavasana. Your arms can get a little wider away from your body. Breath softer. And then just notice what you're holding on to. Notice if you can get softer. Notice if your spine can get heavier and what you are willing and able to surrender here. Notice the thoughts in your mind's eye slow down. Surrender in those moments might feel challenging to you, but can be made simple with this lesson. Simply repeat, in your soft space of Shavasana, or your soft space of your peaceful meditation, where would you have me go? What would you have me do? What would you have me say, and to whom? Offer yourself up to these questions. Offer them up and then see the answers come to you. And it could be as simple as just softening into that. Knowing that the weight of the world is not on your back. Instead, ask the universe, where would you have me go? What would you have me do? What would you have me say, and to whom? When you feel like you've surrendered, surrender a little bit more.
All you are is love. Light. Ease. And joy. The light of each of you is all I feel in this moment. Stay in your cozy space of rest for as long as you need. From my heart to yours, namaste.